Hey everyone, it is the Angry Honey Badger, and it is time for the next League of Legends patch notes. I'm not even going to really try to rush my way through this patch notes because I know it's going to be really long because it's been a while since we've had a patch in League, mostly because of all of the tournaments and the World Championships and all of that fun stuff. They try not to change anything in the game while they're doing all of that because it can screw up team comps and metas and all that fun stuff that teams have been doing, and it can kind of throw them for a loop, so they don't try to change anything, and that's why we haven't seen very many changes in the game. I know there's been a lot of talk about things that are going to happen, and they've been doing some previews, so now we can actually see what all they're going to do in this next patch. So we will go ahead and start off. Really, we got all types of things happening. It's kind of cool. So things will be changing drastically in some cases, like the changes to the Twisted Tree line, because it's being completely remade. There's the picture up here. It's kind of cool. I'm excited for it. It's going to definitely change that. I have a little 3v3 ranked team that I play with, and we're excited for next season. We did okay this season. We didn't play that many, but we did all right, and we're interested to see how the map's going to go and see how team comps work on 3v3, so maybe look forward to some games of that coming up in the future for fun. But other than that, what we're going to be looking at now is some new items being added. We have, first off, the Blackfire Torch. Its recipe to create it is a Cage's Lucky Pick and a Catalyst. And then you can see its gold and combined costs, 50 AP, 300 health, 350 mana, and a unique passive that your spells burn for an additional 5% of their target's maximum health and magic damage over 3 seconds. So, kind of a cool item. We're gonna have to see how some of these work. These are definitely gonna be changing builds a little bit around. We'll see though how more of this is gonna work later. So let's see what we got. Next we have something that we're gonna be calling the Witch Cap. Similar to the Death Cap, its recipe is gonna be involving a needlessly large rod. You can see its total cost of 2700. And then we have 100 ability power coming from it. And then uniquely passive-wise, we have 10% move speed, and then another passive that increases the ability power by 25%. Sounds like a really cool item to me. I'm interested to see how that is going to work out. Next, we have a Blood Mail, the Overlord's Blood Mail. The recipe for that would be a Giant's Belt and a Ruby Crystal. Its total gold cost you can see there is 2565. 850 health, which is going to be nice, and then a passive on a killer and assist, you heal for 200 HP over 5 seconds. So kind of a nice little catalyst thing working in there. Next we have Lord Van Damme's Pillager. We have the recipe of a Heart of Gold and a Brutalizer, kind of taking some damage and some health items together. 2962 is that cost, 40 attack damage, 350 health, a passive of 10% cooldown reduction probably coming from that Brutalizer, and then we're getting a little bit of Spell Vamp from that, oddly enough. So kind of a hybrid item it would appear, since you're getting attack damage and Spell Vamp. That'll work great on characters like maybe Akali, Kale, Jax, other fun people like that. Alright, moving on, we have a new Lantern moving here. We got a Razor that builds into it, Madrid's, total cost 1200, 25 attack damage, 30 armor, a passive where your basic attacks against minions and monsters have 20% chance to deal 300 bonus magic damage. Sounds pretty similar to a Riggle's Lantern. And the unique active, a stealth detecting mist grants vision in a target area for 10 seconds. It's got a 1 minute cooldown. Kind of works like clairvoyance. So it's kind of cool. I've seen it work in the public beta. It definitely is going to be a nice little on-spot ward action. If you don't want to run to a bush, you can check it real quick by just kind of doing that little mist. So that'll be kind of cool. Next we have the Wicked Hatchet. We have a recipe of a Cloak of Agility and a Long Sword. It's 1955 cost-wise total. You got 20 attack damage, 18% critical chance to strike on them, and then your unique passive, your basic attack, inflicts grievous wounds on enemy champions, causing 50% reduced healing and regeneration for 1.5 seconds. So, another little item there. Next, we have the Blade of the Ruined King. It's got a Blade Water Cutlass, which is kind of awesome. I wanted to see that item worked into other things. It's got a total cost of 2825, 40 attack damage, 10% lifesteal. Wish it had a little bit more. We have a unique passive that your attacks deal 4% of the target's current health and magic damage and deals you for half the amount. But that's probably why it only has 10% lifesteal. So, Ignore my comment before. And then a unique active, which drains the target champion, dealing 150% physical damage plus 50% of your attack damage and healing you by the same amount. Additionally, you steal 30% of their movement speed. This item sounds awesome, personally. It's going to be kind of fun. Little bit of lifesteal to help you in lane. Awesome passive and active to help you beat down someone pretty fast as an AD champion. So that's going to be a new, fun, cool item to use. Next, we have another little item, something small. Oh, what we got here, actually, are new consumables. So click to consume, and all that fun stuff. Gonna ignore those for now. Anyways, they're cool. I mean, increased damage to turrets for 4 minutes, attack damage, you know, illumination and rage. So, all right, we're gonna move on now to the champion changes. Some of these, I think some of you know what is coming. And we'll see how this goes. Anyways, so we have Blitzcrank. His base health is being reduced to 518 from 568. And the health per level is going to be reduced as well by 5. So not huge changes, but definitely going to be affecting him early game. So something to pay attention to with Blitzcrank. But he's pretty strong right now. Next, we have Evelynn. Agony's Embrace ability power ratio is being reduced to 1% every 50 ability power instead of 1% for every 100 ability power instead of 1% for every 50 ability power that she was getting for that bonus. So basically you just get less percentage damage on her ultimate. It makes sense because it was hurting people a lot. And that teamed up with a Deathfire Grass was making her kind of the ultimate quick assassin. So they're going to be doing that change to her for now. The next change that we have is Ezreal. His Essence Flux no longer reduces the enemy's attack speed. They're just trying to even him out a little bit more now. If you get into a 1v1 and he lands that, you don't really have to worry as much. You can probably actually 1v1 him now. Before, that was taking you to a point where you probably couldn't 1v1 him as another AD character, or AD carry champion. Next, we have Jace receiving some nerfs. His Thundering Blow no longer deals any flat damage. Instead, it deals percentage max damage, max health damage, and has a bonus attack damage ratio. They fixed the stun to no longer sometime last beyond the knockback duration. And then the acceleration grant mana cost has been increased for him on that. He might see future nerfs. I know a lot of people think he's strong. And he is strong if he's played really well. So maybe in the future we'll see other ones. But hopefully for now that Thundering Blow will correct him and kind of put him in a better spot. Next we have a change to Leona. They fixed the Shield of Daybreak's cooldown and now matches its tooltip. Mordekaiser. They have fixed the Mace of Spades, now damages wards properly. Poppy is seeing a fix, Devastating Blow, now damages wards properly. So a couple little fixes there for those folks. Now, next we have Rengar getting beat to death with the Nerf Stick. His health, or his base health, regeneration has been reduced to 4 from 8. His health regeneration per level has been reduced to 0.4 from 0.8. The Bone Tooth Necklace no longer grants a base 10 attack damage. Savagery Empowered attack damage ratio has been reduced to 2.0 from 2.5. And Thrill of the Hunt stealth duration has been reduced to 5 seconds from 7. And the cooldown has been increased on it at all levels. This is their attempts to obviously make him a little bit more fair. We'll see how this really affects him. If you haven't been buying Bone Tooth Necklace, it was an awesome item. You should have been buying it, as I've said. Losing that 10 attack damage will maybe have you not buy it as early now, since it's not going to give you quite as much early game. So it'll allow you to kind of move on with your build. As for the other changes, I can see why they did them. I'm kind of afraid of that base health regen and the health regen per level going down. I didn't really think those were problems with him. I know they tried to fix some other stuff with his Savagery Empowered attack damage ratio. That doesn't bother me as much. It should have been touched a little bit there. I don't think that's too much. It makes sense for them to do some changes to Rengar. But overall, hopefully this doesn't hurt him too much. It's going to change him a little bit. As for the build that I did for him, it should stay about the same, though. This hasn't been like a rework, so he's still pretty much the same. Just some new changes, and maybe you can't jump into a few of them now and get away with it quite as easily. Next, we got some changes to Skarner happening. His exoskeleton cooldown has been increased, and Impale no longer inflicts casting if the target escapes the range during the cast time. This change kind of needed to happen. I know a lot of people like Skarner. I like Skarner. I think he's a really, really good jungler. I'd say he's probably in the top five for best junglers in the game. You know, this is them trying to make him a little bit, I don't know, more similar to other junglers, because he's got strong jungle presence and ganking presence, so a little change to him. Next, we have the Sona. Base health has been reduced by 40, and base armor has been reduced as well. Sona is pretty strong. I know she's pretty weak in terms of you can kill her fast, but she does really good damage early game. So I think this is them countering that. If she pokes her head up to come do that damage she does, you can fight her back now a little bit more effectively this way. So we'll see how this changes her. Hopefully this doesn't make her too squishy, but I don't think that'll be the case, but we'll have to keep our eye on this. Next, we have more changes to Syndra. There were changes for her in the last patch a while ago. What we have now is Force of Will now grabs nearest Dark Sphere in range if no valid target was selected. The grab time has been reduced a little bit, which is nice. Throw commands given during the grab time now execute immediately after grabbing finishes. So a little fix there too on minions, Dark Spheres, blah, 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 blah. Shadow of the Weak, Dark Spheres have nearly finished casting, will now get knocked back once they arrive, and they fixed more bugs with that too, when it was afflicted with Dark Sphere, blah, 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 more fun stuff there. And then Unleashed Power, the spell shields will now only block a single spear rather than the entire spell, and now also pulls the cheered cast just before, as you can tell I'm just reading this now. Blah, 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 blah. Anyways, to sum up her changes, nothing really ability power ratio damage and all that fun stuff, but lots of fixes and cast time changes and little things that are going to help her become a more consistent champion. I've been avoiding making a build video for her. I kind of want to because I do have her and I think she's fun to play, but there's just these little things like that grab time reduction is going to help and just a bunch of little things that were just holding her back as a champion. I think once you get her down, she's really fun and she can work really well. Similar to Orianna, kind of how she does. But Orianna's seen changes because some of these complicated champions with all these damn orbs and throwing them back and forth and moving things around, it takes a little bit for them to completely work out all the kinks in these champions. So I'm excited to see if this kind of helps bring her together as a champion. So hopefully it does. Next we have Tristana. Explosive Shot cast range now matches her attack range. They fixed Rocket Jump. It's now more reliable when used around terrain. It was not before. You would hit things and kind of bounce off of them and you wouldn't go where you wanted. And then the Buster Shot mana cost has been reduced by 40, so that'll help her use that a little better. Next, we have Trundle. Rapid Bite mana cost has decreased from 40 to 30. Contaminates cast animation no longer locks Trundle out of using other abilities. A couple small changes to Trundle there, nothing much. Mana cost decrease is going to be nice for him. I like to see this happen to Trundle because I like Trundle. Next, we have Twisted Fate. They have fixed Pick a Card, now damages wards correctly. And that is the changes for enemy champions. So, all that was going on. Like I said, Rengar kind of got the worst of it, it seems. And all the other changes seem mostly appropriate for now. And we'll go with that for the champion changes. Next, we take a look at items in the game. There are ward skins, which they are adding. If you have not seen, you can go to leagueoflegends.com and see what they did for that. There's some cool ones coming out. The ward skins will be available for you to unlock and use all of that. There are some changes, though, to some existing items, as we can see now. Deathfire Grasp no longer grants cooldown reduction. The active base damage has been reduced to 15% of current health from 25%, and the ability power ratio increased to 5% per 100 ability power ratio from 4%. So, nerf buff, we'll see how it works out. Deathfire Grasp was becoming a very, very popular item recently because a lot of people are finding out about its full potential. It was working really well on a few assassin-y champions that they had released and, well, not released, but reworked. As you know, Evelynn, it was working incredibly well with her. So, they kind of made a change to it. Hopefully they didn't nerf it so bad that nobody buys it, but my guess is nobody's going to start buying it for a little while, especially with it missing that cooldown reduction. Next, we have a change to the Phage. The slow duration has been reduced to 2 seconds from 2.5, and the slow range for attack has been reduced to 20% from 30%, which then for the Trinity Force will get affected by this. The slow for attack ranges has been reduced to 25% from 35%. And then also, this will affect the frozen mallet, as we can see. The slow duration now correctly lasts for 2.5 seconds instead of 2 seconds. All right, I lied there. It didn't fix it. It just changed it, so it actually works better now. So, yay for frozen mallet. Next, we have the Hextech Sweeper. New recipe, it's the Amplifying Tone plus Kindle Gem. Total cost is 1435. Ability power reduced to 40... or reduced from 40 to 25. Sorry, misspoke. And then the active effect increased from 6 seconds to 10 seconds. So, a little bit of a change there. We have a co-op versus AI things. I'm going to skip those because I'm not worried about them. You can read them. And if you're wondering, all of the patch notes, obviously, are at leagueoflegends.com. You can see them there. Or if you log into League, it's usually listed in the news, like in the launch screen. So all of that's happening too. In case you want to go check out any of these or reread over these patch notes, never a bad idea. I always like to familiarize myself with the patch notes completely before I jump in after a new patch, just so I'm not surprised by something. Because before you know it, you jump into a game with Evelynn and you go to buy Deathfire Grasp and then you run to go kill someone and you're like, what happened to my damage? Because that's going to happen now. We're going to see less Evelynns because of it. Other than that, guys, there are some general changes I'm not going to go over because this has been plenty long enough for a video. You can read them here, though, if you pause it and go full screen. If you want to keep hanging out in this video, you could actually tell me what your thoughts are down below in the comment section, whether you like some of these changes or not. I have a feeling some of you will not like these changes, but that's because no one ever likes change, unless it's good change. So, you know, they could nerf other champions, I think. But other than that, guys, that'll be this video, and I'll just see all of you in the next video.